Hi, and welcome to this Blue Planet Unified Assurance and Analytics 5G Network Slice Showcase. Today I'll show the visualization of end-to-end network slice KPIs and the localization of SLA violations. If I switch across to the standard UAA view, you can see the alarms and events, but today we're going to focus on the 5G Network Slice dashboard. This dashboard provides an overall summary of the health of the network slices. In this environment, we can see that we've got a total of 50 network slices being monitored across multiple cell sites. And we can see that we've got 6 SLA violations. And we can see that there are 4 sites contributing to the violations. For example, where a cell site might be supporting more than one slice type. Below that, we can actually see a breakdown in terms of the different slice types. For example, mass machine type communication, ultra low latency connection, enhanced mobile broadband. And we can see the level of compliance, you know, whether or not they're compliant, at risk, or there are violations. We can also see here a breakdown in terms of what's causing those violations, whether or not it's due to, for example, latency, availability, and throughput. We can also see a breakdown in terms of alarm severities. Below that, we've got a table here that's showing our 6 violations, and we can see that we've got the slice type, we've got the slice name, we've got the instance of the slice to the specific cell site. If there is any customers impacted, we've got them listed here. And we've got details of specific problems. So, for example, we can see that we got an end-to-end uplink delay for this particular network slice. If we drill into this, we're shown a specific view that helps us explain what's going on. What we see at the top here is we can see that we've got lines showing the different KPIs from the 3GP standards, you know, the TS28554. And we can see the arrows indicate the directionality. So we can see straight away that we're reporting an end-to-end KPI problem between the UE to the UPF. And we can see here also the breakdown in terms of the other KPIs, for example, the SDAP, the radio link control, the UU, the F1, and the N3. But very quickly, you can visualize, actually, whilst we've got an end-to-end problem, the problems here on the F1U. Now, we can also see that it's related to a transport problem. But before we dive into that, I just want to show you a few other things. For those different KPIs, we can see straight away based on the default filters, we've just focused in on the KPIs that are causing us problems. So we, for example, we've got that end-to-end between the UE and the UPF. We can see its current value is 13 milliseconds, where there's an SLA for the ultra low latency connection of 10 milliseconds. And we can also see that we've got the F1 between the DU and the CUUP, its current value. And also we've got the virtual resource utilization shown here, saying that for the CPU, we got a threshold set at 85 and it's actually running at 88%. We can also show you all the different KPIs that we monitor. So these are aligned to the 3GPP standards. I'm showing you all the different SLAs that we monitor. We've also got a tab here that shows us the specific alarms we got. So we got an alarm raise for that virtual resource utilization. Now, the other thing we can do is we can also drill into the transport network. So this is launching our routing optimization and analytics platform. Now, what Blue Planet Rower allows you to do is it allows you to basically investigate and troubleshoot problems in a complex packet network. So in that mid-haul problem on the F1 between the DU and the CU, if we look at the latency here, we can see that this is the current problem we have. This adds up to greater than the SLA that we showed earlier on and the KPI view. If we run back in time, so if I look at this now, this is showing us the current time, but if I move to here, I can actually see, and if I pause this, we can see how the traffic routed through the network before we had a problem. Now, if we continue through this, and I stop it here, we can see that we actually got a link failure here. And this link failure then forced all the traffic to go this way through the network. And we can see shortly that the latency is spiked. Now, why is that latency spiked? I suspect, and let's confirm it, it was caused due to congestion. So we can see that the congestion probably meant that the device was queuing the traffic. We can also see additional information down here about all the interfaces and links and connections associated to the packet network. But if we go back to the the main demo. Just want to show you a few extra things on this display. But before I do, just to confirm that we collect the end-to-end KPIs, we collect the alarms and events from the different network devices. We don't actually collect information about the UE, but they are anchor points for the KPIs defined by the 3GPP. And we can also look at the slice details. And this gives us, you know, a logical topology of the network. And as you can see, we could also highlight that our problem was on the connection between the DU and the CUP. And that's kind of it for this demo. Thank you.